So you've had shoulder pain for a long time. You've tried a home exercise program, you've tried physical therapy, you've tried pain medications, and you may have even tried cortisone injections. The pain is disturbing your sleep, it's affecting your work, and it's impacting your day-to-day activities. I want you to take a look at these results. This data is from a study looking at PRP treatment for shoulder pain, and they are incredible. Pain improvement and functional improvement for over 6 months. Multiple recent studies conclude that PRP injections work for all types of shoulder pain, including rotator cuff tears, shoulder impingement, and rotator cuff tendinopathy. Let's talk about PRP treatment for shoulder pain. Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Pang here. Now, if this is the first time you are watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, has become widespread in the treatment of professional athletes, college athletes, weekend warriors, the industrial athlete, and anyone else who wants to live a healthy and active lifestyle, but are held back and limited by painful conditions. PRP injections fall under a big umbrella category called orthobiologics, or regenerative medicine. It's being used to treat a variety of orthopedic conditions, such as injuries to muscles, tendons, ligaments, bones, and joints. But do they really work, and what does the data show us about people who get PRP treatment for shoulder pain? Now, it's important to point out that older studies using PRP injections to treat shoulder pain had conflicting results. Some studies suggested great benefits. Other studies had more disappointing results. But the more we learn about PRP and the more we refine our technique, we are starting to see better results. The most recent studies published in 2021 are all trending towards excellent outcomes. Let's take a closer look at some of these studies. This first one was a randomized control trial comparing platelet-rich plasma injection to steroid injection in those who have a partial tear in their rotator cuff. Patients were divided into a group that got one cortisone injection and another group that got one platelet-rich plasma injection. The researchers found that at 1 month follow-up, there was no difference between pain and functional outcomes between the two groups. Both groups improved. But at 6 months, the group that got the PRP injection had significantly better pain scores as well as functional scores compared to the cortisone group. And this makes sense. A cortisone injection is like putting a big dose of ibuprofen into the shoulder. It will help improve pain and it will help improve symptoms, but we all know the effects of ibuprofen eventually wear off, and so do the effects of cortisone. But not PRP. The effects of PRP are sustainable long term. Let's look at another study. This study looked at 50 patients who all had chronic shoulder pain. All of them had gone through physical therapy, including cryotherapy, ultrasound treatment, stretching exercises, and rotator cuff strengthening. They had taken non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications such as ibuprofen and naproxen, and they had all tried a cortisone injection in the shoulder, but despite all of these interventions, they had persistent pain. The researchers then gave each of them one PRP treatment in their shoulder and then continued to follow their progress. After the PRP injection, all mobility parameters that were evaluated in the study improved significantly. They had better pain and they had better functional scores. 32 of these 50 patients were also involved in sports, and of these 32 people, 84% returned to playing sports and 78% were able to get back to playing at the same high level pre-injury. The authors conclude that in most patients with refractory rotator cuff tendinopathy, subarachnoid injections of PRP significantly decreased pain, improved functional outcomes, and resolved sleep disturbances. Moreover, most of the athletes returned to sport at the same level they had before the injury. Now, that was a quick summary of some recent clinical trials looking at PRP treatment for shoulder pain. But now I want to help you understand the why and the how of PRP injections. Why does PRP work? What are the platelets doing? And I firmly believe that if you understand the concept behind this, you will understand why so many orthopedists and sports medicine specialists are so excited about utilizing PRP injections to help treat those who are in pain. And the best way to understand this is the following analogy. Let's say that I fall and have a big cut over my forearm. It's red, it's hot, it's swollen, it's angry, it hurts. Over time, a scab forms over the forearm. The scab falls off, revealing this pink-white looking granulation tissue, and the tissue continues to remodel and give it many months, and I have brand new skin. This entire healing process is initiated and controlled by platelets. Our platelets are responsible for tissue healing, tissue remodeling, tissue proliferation, and most importantly, in controlling pain and inflammation. And so what we're doing with the platelet-rich plasma injection is using your own body's capacity to control pain and to control inflammation, taking it out, concentrating it, and then injecting it under ultrasound guidance back into an area that's been irritated or injured. And this is why we think PRP injections have so much potential in the treatment of orthopedic conditions. Before, we gave cortisone injections to help treat pain, and cortisone is a steroid. And like I said before, you can think of steroid injections like injecting a big dose of ibuprofen. And we all know the effects of ibuprofen are temporary. Again, look at this graph. The people who got cortisone injections plateaued after 1 month, but the people who got PRP injections continue to show improvements in pain and functional outcomes. And we think the reason for that is because PRP injections contain an incredible amount of growth factors which can help with tissue healing and pain relief. Just like how my laceration will continue to remodel and will continue to heal, the effects of the PRP injection can be sustained for a long period of time. Many of my patients who have learned about PRP injections and have examined the data have decided to proceed with treatment. Many choose to get PRP treatment concurrently with a home rehabilitation program or physical therapy to help treat their shoulders. And if you're looking for an example home exercise program, check out this video next. I talk about why people get shoulder pain in the first place, and then I go over the best exercises to fix the problem. Thanks for watching.